is from 1942. Bob Plantet was the director. Bob Plantet was working actually at that time, or as the writer of this, Theodore Gazelle, also known as Dr. Seuss, was working at Frank Capra's film unit for the military and knew a lot of the Warner Brothers guys because they were all working there as well on private staff room films. 1940, he wrote Court Patch and DA. It's a big hit book, and it seemed to be the perfect one to make a movie about.
Yeah, it's one of the first Dr. Seuss book adaptations. I think it's rarely shown these days, mainly because that's a lot of Bob Clampett's ideas and crazy things like the strange Peter Lorre fish at the end, blows his brains out, suicide gag. So if you're sensitive to that,
just close your eyes. Also, I found out this is the only Warner Brothers animated short of all however many they made, Jerry, which is a lot, that actually was based on a pre-existing book that was still under copyright at the time. So that's my little trip. Also, sorry, Jerry, I'm going to do this.
Go ahead.
Horton has to sing the Hot Stuff song, which was a novelty song.
Yes, he warned me he was going to talk about it.
I am going to sing it for you. Hot Stuff Ball sits on the river rock and a brawl up, brawl up to it. Hot Stuff Ball sits on the river rock and a brawl up to it.
Yay! That reminds me, we're going to show Screwball Swirl.
Which is next, Screwball Swirl, 1944 from Tex Avery.
This was Avery was one of the fathers of Bugs Bunny, and when he got let go at Warner Brothers, and he got picked up by MGM to kind of be their B unit, because Hanna-Barbera were the A units of Tom and Jerry, and he didn't really have any mandate other than to make miscellaneous cartoons, but the pressure was on for him to come up with new characters they could exploit, you know. And he was not really into that. He was more into the gags and the crazy situations. And Screwball Squirrel's clearly, whether it was on high or he was trying to repeat himself, somebody said, make another Bugs Bunny for us. Bugs was so popular. And this was their attempt to do that. Based on what I know, Avery didn't want to do another Bugs Bunny, and he tried to make this character as obnoxious as he could.
And he is completely obnoxious. He's so obnoxious, they only made five Screwball films. This is the first one.
Right.
And then finally, this is kind of an interesting one. It's all the cats join in. It's actually part of what they call a compilation or package feature that Disney was doing in the 1940s, mostly during World War II and after World War II. These were feature lengths, but they were actually cat little segments. And all the cats join in is one of 10 segments in a feature called Make My Music.
Disney, after the war and the strike and all this stuff that happened to them after Bambi, they literally took them a long time to regroup and get their act together to make feature-length films like Cinderella, you know, Peter Pan, which came out about in the 1950s. So they put all their efforts into these shorts, these elaborate shorts. There was no real money in doing silly symphonies like Short Subjects anymore. The only way to do this would be to package them as features, which they did. They're all based around music. This one, of course, is Freddie Moore,
the
designer, animator, fantastic. He did was very well known for his sexy girl, his cute characters. This one's a real tour de force.
And it's Benny Goodman's orchestra music. So that's what we're going to leave you with. We'll see you again in a little while.
We'll be right back.